Okay, we're ready for takeoff. Let's go save some dogs.
Potomac traffic, Columbia 22 Foxtrot, departing runway 24 Potomac, straight out departure.
And full throttle. And we just launch. Look at an airspeed, 60 knots. Looking for 72. 65, 67, 72, back pressure. And off in the air we go.
The situation is, in the south, because of
really good today.
Lax spay and neutering practices, there are lots of puppies. And so there are more dogs than there are people. So they wind up taking these dogs to local shelters, many of which are high kill shelters. That basically means if the dog isn't adopted during a certain period or has got any illness or is too old, they'll put him to sleep. They gas him. They put him in a chamber, carbon dioxide, and suffocate him. My name is Michael Young, and I'm an adjunct professor at George Mason University. I teach in the Electrical Engineering Department and the IT Department. For the IT Department, I teach wireless communications and networking, which is my area of expertise. What I like to do in my spare time is fly. I have a commercial pilot's license, instrument rated. I'm a certified flight instructor and instrument flight instructor. I have over 3,000 hours logged, and I have my own airplane. I used to fly for any reason I could find until a couple of years ago, a friend of mine sent me an email about some dogs that needed to be transported from, actually it was Myrtle Beach up to Delaware. And I'd lost my German Shepherd just a few months prior to that, to cancer. And so I said, you know what, that may be a good reason to fly. So I flew those dogs up. It was two German Shepherds, coincidentally enough. And then I got involved with the dog rescue program, and I've done, I don't know, maybe 45, 50 dog rescue flights, 230 dogs. In fact, I got one tomorrow and one on Sunday. There are lots of rescues in the north that have relationship with these high-kill shelters. And they transport these dogs from these high-kill shelters up to rescues where they'll go to foster homes and be put up for adoption. What we rescue pilots do is have relationship with the sending rescues and receiving rescues, and we fly and pick these dogs up, and we bring them to a receiving rescue who will put the dogs up for adoption. On my third dog rescue flight, I got my Molly. She never made it to the destination in Staten Island, New York. She came home with me. And then 6 months later, I got her a dog, a little puppy, which is now bigger than her. And that was Biff. And I love my dogs. They're great. It's really a thrill to be able to see somebody and you hand them their dog. That just before this, they never saw the dog except the picture on the internet, and now they get the dog. So that's a rewarding thing, because I know I love my dogs, and I know all these dogs are just so lovable and can give love, and it's just a shame that they're putting them to sleep. So I'm just doing my small part to make this all happen.
Tunk approach, this is Columbia 2522 Foxtrot 7000.
Hold on to me as we go.
For you. Make it easy.
As we roll down this unfamiliar road.
Roger, 2-2-Fox.
And although this way.
Alright, I'm gonna go all the way down to 1500 feet.
Oh, looky what I got.
Just know
it's okay. You can stay here.
Cause I'm gonna make this place your home. Settle down.
All right, doing a descent about 7 foot a minute because we got to get under Class B airspace. So, everybody yawn. Tell the puppies to yawn.
Potomac traffic, Columbia 22 Foxtrot, turning final runway 24 Potomac. Right into the sun.
Oh,
And I don't know who's the better for it, the dog that got rescued or the person who rescued the dog.
Look at this cute guy. He's just so, he's so relaxed after his long flight up from North Carolina. He's saying, I just want to chill. I don't want anything big. I'm just chilling. Take it easy. And by the way, feed me too. Give me a bath as well. You stink.